Hello everyone, in this video we are going to be solving problems on addition and subtraction of surds. This is a continuation of the series of problems we've been solving on surds. To see an earlier video, just click on the link at the top right hand corner of the screen. Before getting started on addition and subtraction of surds, we need to know what is called similar surds. Okay, there we have it, similar surds. These are surds with the same radical. Of course, radical is another word for surd. What do I mean by this? Let's give an example. The square root of 2 is a surd. 2 root 2 is another surd. 3 root 2 is another one. So, 2 root 2 is a multiple of root 2. 3 root 2 is also a multiple of root 2. So, we can see here that all three surds have the same radical. So these three surds are similar. So one more example. Let's consider root 5 and root 20. On an initial thought, we would think these two surds are not similar, but they are. The fact that they do not have the same numbers under the square root does not mean that they are not similar. What we just have to do is to simplify root 20, and we did this in the previous video. So to do this, we are going to have to detach 20 into the product of two numbers. The options are 1 and 20, 2 and 10, and 4 and 5. This first one is not going to make the cuts because it's not going to advance our cause. Now the second one is also not going to work because neither of these two numbers is a perfect square. But 4 and 5 would work because 4 is a perfect square. So the square root of 20 is going to simplify to the square root of 4 times 5. And from one of the rules of surds, that the square root of AB is equal to the root of A times the root of B. So I would have root of 4 times root of 5. So the square root of 4 is 2. So I've got a 2 root 5 here. So we can see that square root of 5 and square root of 20 are similar surds because root of 20 is 2 root 5, which has the same radical as the square root of 5. Now, why is the knowledge of similar surds important? Similar surds are important when the addition and subtraction of surds are discussed because surds that are not similar cannot be added, neither can they be subtracted. Addition and subtraction can only be performed on surds if the surds are similar. For example, there is no way I would be able to work out square root of 2 plus the square root of 3 without using my calculator. There is no way I can simplify this further. I cannot do that. But it's going to be very easy for me to work out the square root of 2 plus 3 root 2. Because what I have here is 1 root 2. So like I said in the previous video, this can be seen as though, the radical can be seen as though it's a letter. So if I take root 2 as a letter, so this is going to be 1a, and 3 root 2 is going to be 3a. And a plus 3a is 4a, perhaps a can just be an apple. So by virtue of that, root 2 plus 3 root 2 is just going to be 4 root 2. But I cannot do the same here. For addition and subtraction are only possible with similar surds. Okay, let's take the first example. Now we are going to have to add 4 root 3 plus the square root of 75. I know you are thinking, oh, they are not similar surds. But let's just see if 75 can be reduced into a surd that includes a root of 3. I think we can do that because this is in its lowest term. 4 root 3 is just 4 root 3. We cannot do much about that. So here, I've got 4 root 3 So the next thing is going to be for us to detach 75 into the product of two numbers, wherein one of the numbers would be a perfect square. Because I've got a number of options, but the one I'm going to go for would be 3 times 25, because 25 is a square number. So in place of 75, I'm going to have 3 times 25. So this is 4 root 3 plus, so using this rule at the top, I can split the square roots. So that's going to give root 3 times the square root of 25. This is 4 root 3 plus root 3. Now root 25 is 5. So this is just times 5. And I'm just going to have my 5 root 3 here. So this is equal to, so I can see that these two sorts are similar. 4 root 3 plus 5 root 3, that's 9 root 3. Let's take another one, example 2. So the first thing we need to check for is if these two sorts are similar. We can see that 5 root 2 is in its lowest form, so I'm just going to return 5 root 2. So let's see if root 96 can be splitted into the product of two numbers. So the square root of 96, that's going to be 49 times 2. So in place of 96, I'm just going to have 49 times 2. So this is 5 root 2. So 49 times 2 underneath the square roots. So I can split the square root. I'm going to get root 49 times the square root of 2. This is 5 root 2 minus, 49 is a square number, so its root is 7 times root 2, that's just 7 root 2. So we can see that these two sorts are similar. 5 root 2 minus 7 root 2 is a negative 2 root 2. So I'm going to be needing. So here is the last question, root 18 minus root 50 plus root 32. So all three numbers are different, but we can simplify each one of them to see if they are similar sorts. So for 18, we need to split this into the product of two numbers. One of the numbers must be a perfect square. And of course, this is going to be 9 times 2. So in place of 18, I'm going to have square root of 9 times 2. I'm going to do the same for 50. The two numbers would be 25 and 2. So instead of 50, I'm going to have 25 times 2 underneath the square roots. Now, similarly, for 32, the two numbers would be 16 and 2 because 16 is a square number. Next is to split the square roots, going by this rule. So the root of 9 times 2 is going to be the root of 9 times the root of 2 minus the root of 25 times 2 would be the root of 25 times the root of 2. Then plus root 16 times 2 would be root 16 times the root of 2. So the square root of 9 is 3. So I've got 3 times root 2, and that's just 3 root 2 minus the root of 25 is 5. 5 times root 2 is 5 root 2. Then plus, the square root of 16 is 4, times root 2 is 4 root 2. So I've got 3 root 2 minus 5 root 2 plus 4 root 2. And if this is going to confuse you, just assume that the square root of 2 is a letter, say A. So you can just compare all of this with 3A minus 5A plus 4. A. So 3a minus 5a is a negative 2a, then plus 4a is a positive 2a. So our final answer here is going to be 2 with 2.
I hope you found this video useful. If you did, kindly like, subscribe, and share it. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.